production rate per year number of HAL has been flagged for many years and now it's in public domain. On top, HAL has been accusing IAF of not ordering more Russian jets recently. In a paper, HAL mentioned making Su-35-4 squadrons quickly in HAL facilities with limited changes. IAF wrote back saying acquisition cost versus present Mk2 will increase by almost 20% for Su-35 on CAPEX side and maintenance cost will rise up by 50% approx over OPEX side. IAF also rebuked stating instead of HAL suggesting Russian jets, priority should be focused on LCA project and meaning squadron numbers first over any other new project. IAF also submitted to MOD a report stating how such low production rates are hurting IAF more over anything else. In a strongly worded message, MOD has told HAL to focus on meeting deadlines over fretting for order books position. MOD/GOI had sanctioned internally the amalgamation of AMCA and LCA Mk2 projects. Primarily each of these planes will have the technology and technical assistance with two major aerospace giants. Each of these giants will work in isolated cells comprising of either DA or LM with DRDO/ADA/HAL. At no point of time, there will be a direct interaction between DA and LM but the plane, LCA Mk2 and AMCA, parts, subsystems and every level of the blueprint is charted out to be sourced from our indigenous project and DRAL and Tata LMJV based ecosystem. LCA Mk2 interior housing and cell manufacturing is primarily based out of F-16 with inside space, mounts and orientation drawing from the very best of LM and DA expertise and changes made accordingly. In a brief, the Mk2 project is like 50% with HAL/ADA/DRDO, 30% with LM and 20% with DA and the ecosystem supported by DRAL and Tata. AMCA is reverse of this number with 50% with HAL/ADA/DRDO, 30-35% with DA and 15-20% LM subject to critical tech flowing from LM into AMCA or else DA will take more stake in percent terms shared with ADA/HAL. This critical tech of LM is allowing F-35 subsystems and integration from IDRA, Israeli F-35 systems. Though LM and USGov has made it clear that F-35 access is only after F-16 acceptance by India in considerable numbers. A separate G2G F-35 deal is supposed to have time slot closer to 2028 plus without priority clearance from Senate, POTUS, thus a greater push is by F-16 deal and getting accorded the priority purchase. With recent IAF infrastructure plan with the French side, LM has upgraded the F-16 capability further. The drone command system of F-35 is now for integration for Indian F-16 from day one and is pushed as an add-on relaxation, goody. This drone command system will enable F-16s and later users, like F-35s and in future IAF once Rafale's F-4.2/AMCA, to command Guardian and Avenger NG. To the IAF query on large IR and overweight of the gracefully aged F-16, there is a material change proposed by LM for the overall body of F-16 which will make it lighter and incorporate semi-stealth features to keep it relevant for next 30-40 years. To the main contention about new F-16 finding it difficult versus more modern fighters, LM has assured MOD that it will prove its superiority and relevance. To this MOD has gone ahead with IAF recommendation of a technical evaluation but added one more plane to the list of contenders, F-16, Gripen E and MiG-35. The underlying thought process is that winner is pre-decided but the process must be followed to show relevancy and performance in a fair evaluation for the public. The likely reason is to keep matters transparent for not letting any political opposition in future. Also, other planes won't get cleared for the competition owing to a minimal cost, footprint, OPEX and forward base stationing plus usage primarily for all missions. This clears the way of the two main MIT projects, one for Rafale via DRAL route and one for F-16/F-35 under SB route. Next up is the timeline which will get firmed up soon. Expected to finalize soon is the technical assistance in LCA Mk1A, to be inducted in sufficiently large order. Project by DA and agreement of AMCA assistance by DA between GOI and French government bodies during Pres Macron visit. For the Rafale follow-on orders, the premises have become much bigger. Beyond doubt, The plan for refail numbers is clearly there, with the rest of the plan now shaping firmly up and becoming more clearer. On Super Upgrade, the ALEZ is coming up with a bigger size and higher powered RBE2 ASA radar for Super MKI. Draw will make parts for Qatari and other new deals, and India will try and swing few orders by its way as part of multination efforts. There is also a delinking of the earlier insistence of US government for MLs, aircrafts and E-2D Hawkeye as a package. The three main components, the French assistance and aircraft carriers, Rafale M and also E-2D Hawkeye piecemeal basis order is now allowed. This is a great news, with potentially MRCBF moving towards the change of certain aspects and systems to suit the winning air wing, which will be common for both the carriers. This goes in line with an earlier communique of IF and M clearly asking for Rafales for both the forces. On squadron depletion, there is now lesser worry. The blueprint is now almost clearly spelled out. Important to note, the Russian negotiations for S-400 and S-500 HTK components is not firmed up, with Pres Putin plus Russian delegates wanting India to buy a few more things, including 48 Mi-17 V-5 and Ka-226 Helos, 300 400 new T-90MS, 4 stealth frigates, 2 plus squad MKIs, among other stuff. All other deals need further discussion, including SSN lease and Super MKI. India wants 12 plus S-400 regiments, with minimum 7 plus to be under a Mi project. MiG-35 inclusion is appeasement to get the deal signed on priority. The transition of moving the equipment from present state to more of French, Israeli and US make will be more visible with the conclusion of the deals. Next couple of years will be really busy for MOD, IAF, N and HAL/DA/LM.